Hey Downtimers, today we're going to look at how to make an AoE disc out of a Simply orange juice container. AoE is an area of effect. You could also use the disc for other things as well. We're going to look at those other uses. And so let's get to the table and figure out how to do it. Okay guys, what we're going to use for this, as I said before, is a Simply orange juice container, plastic of course, but now I'm sure there are other containers that you can use for this as well, probably other orange juice containers, so just kind of keep an open mind about the possible containers you might could use for this this AoE disc. Of course we'll need something to cut with, utility knife will work wonders, and we'll need this is optional. We don't have to use a glue gun, but I typically like to use one. On this particular one I'm going to do right now, I might not use it so much, but if you want to make designs on the AoE disc, I recommend you use a glue gun with a low and high setting, and you'll want to use the low setting. Steel wool, and we'll see why in just a moment. Steel wool or very fine sandpaper. And of course, we've got to have these. We've got to have our handy dandy Sharpies. So we've got to have those. Okay. So, first thing we're going to do is cut the bottom out. So, this part's a little bit tricky. We'll want to grab as much of this circle as we can. This, of course, is what we're going for. We want this sun shape on the bottom of the bottle. I'm going to try to cut this where you guys can see it. Be careful with this, especially getting it started. It can be very difficult. Make sure you have a sharp knife. Slow and steady wins the race here. Be sure that you take it easy while you cut this. The plastic is a little bit thick, so accidents can happen if you get carried away or go too fast with it. There we go. Just thought for fun, you know what? I'm going to do two of these. All right. And now we have two of them. Notice the design's a little bit different. And you'll notice they have markings on them. This one shows the markings a little bit more than the other. But they're both basically the same. And they'll both work fine. I did forget to mention that you will need more than a utility knife. I almost forgot to mention, in order to trim this up, we're going to need to use scissors. Okay, make sure you get around the edge here. Just want to cut it as evenly as we can. There we go. That's a little bit better. I'm going to do the other one. Then we'll be ready for the next step. Okay, I did want to mention, these look a little bit different. You notice one's a little bit wider than the other, so I guess it's according to what kind of splash damage or AoE radius or diameter you're dealing with that, you know, you might want to cut one a little bit wider than the other. Maybe one's for a lower level, you know, mage or something. One's for a higher level, you know, druid or whatever. This one's a little bit deformed. I just noticed this. It might end up being a feature. The next step is to get our handy dandy steel wool and start working on these. Now, if you can't get a real good smooth cut around the edges here, you'll want to get maybe an old piece of sandpaper and just work around the edges with that just to make it a little bit smoother. Okay, and I recommend the coarse sandpaper for that. I think that, yeah, this is 100. So this is pretty coarse stuff here. So I recommend the coarse sandpaper for the edges. You want to get those sanded down pretty smooth. It doesn't have to be perfect, but you don't really want it to be sharp or any, you don't want any sharp points on it or any, you know, snags or anything like that. Once you do that, once you get that sanded down around the edges, what you want to do is sand over this. You want it to be a little bit scratched up. You don't want deep gashes or anything like that. I mean, you want the overall effect to be kind of smooth, but you do want some tiny scratches. It dulls the finish of it, which is, it's not that big of a deal. But the reason why we want to do this is because pretty soon we're going to have to use our Sharpies, and we'll want to give our Sharpies a little bit of something to hold on to. And by making little bitty tiny scratches in this, it'll help that out a little bit. You can do these AoE discs without the steel wool and without doing the tiny scratches, and it will look smoother. But the only problem with that is, even with Sharpies, which are the best permanent marker that I know of, even with Sharpies, eventually it will wear off. So that's pretty good. You can see, tell the difference there. You can see there, this one's a little bit duller than this one. So yeah, we want it to be like this. Give that, give those Sharpies a little bit of something to hold on to. One thing I want to do is I want to make one of these a little bit different than the other, but I really like this design better, to be honest with you. I really don't have to do much with that to make a good AoE disc, at least the one that I'm thinking about making. Make sure you have it on low. Just want to be safe with this kind of plastic. If you have it at a really high temperature, it might warp it a little bit, so you don't really want that. So what we're going to do here, we're just going to make some designs and just kind of accent this a little bit. So what I'm doing, I'm just trying to make it kind of start flat there and then work it out so that it looks maybe like something shooting out. Start at the top, and then as you work it away, kind of pull it away. There's only so much you can do with a glue gun, or at least only so much I can do with it. I know lots of folks are much more talented with the glue gun than I am. Just whatever design you want. The great thing about this is, trash to treasure here, so if you don't like what you've done, you can always make another one. Go get some more orange juice, right? The kids will be happy with that. So here's where we get to add whatever designs we like with the hot glue gun. You can add whatever design you like. Of course, the only thing that you're kind of limited by is the template that you already have there that's a bit like a sunburst effect, but you still have some freedom there to do what you like with that. So now for the fun part. This is the part that I enjoy. I need to get a little bit better with my glue gun skills, but this is where it gets really creative, I think. You can use any color you like. I'm going to make this kind of like a sunburst on this one. And I'm going to use this one as kind of like a magical shield. Normally you don't want to go with the outside of the disc first. So you notice I did that. It's kind of a bad habit. I usually do that. But you typically don't want to do that. You want to go with the inside and work your way out, especially if you use the outside to turn with, right? So whatever part of the disc you use to turn, you don't want to color that first. You want to be sure to color that last. You want to let this sit in a low humidity room for probably about 24 hours just to be sure it's dry. But I have made these before without any steel wool or any sanding at all. And I guess it's taken about 24 hours roughly. And they dry up pretty well. I'm gonna make it to where also this one can work as maybe AoE for some sort of fire effect too. So obviously not the best flame job in the world here, but I'm just getting something symbolic that would work for flames and or maybe divine light, sunburst or something like that. So variety is the spice of tabletop role playing games, right? But at the same time, I'm not sure we want to have one disc for every effect in the game, right? I think that might be a little over the top. So I think we're good. We're going with maybe one disc for every, I don't know, two or three, maybe one disc for every 10 effects. I don't know. But one for each would be a little too much, I think. Just too much to keep up with. You would have to have a whole library of discs in some sort of container. The way we do this now is I hand these out to the kids. Whichever disc works for whatever effect their characters may possess or have available to them. They might have two or three spells or effects or special abilities that are kind of related. You know, one might be Divine Light, another might be Sunburst or whatever. And so, you know, the one disc would cover those bases. And that way the player only has to keep up with one disc. So if they've got like five special abilities, really don't want a player, especially my kids who like to, you know, play around a little too much sometimes, don't want them to get carried away. So if you get a little bit off the mark, get you some tissue paper and wipe it off immediately. And you can usually save it. Like I said, it'll take a little while for this to dry. I usually use steel wool for these because I'm not too worried about a little bit of marker coming off, you know, over a few months or whatever. But if you're kind of particular about the markers with the kids or whatever, and you really want to be sure that it really stays on there, you might be wise to just get some fine sandpaper and just use that instead. Now, it's going to mark up the plastic a lot more, but, it's a trade-off. Normally, I'd add a little more color to this one, but for this particular effect, but I decided this time I wouldn't put so much color on it. I wanted it to be a little more transparent, which actually works pretty well because, you'll see here in a moment why we want to be able to see through them. Okay, I'm going to go for something different here. I've never done the, I really like the Sharpies. Here's the metallic Sharpies. These are a lot of fun, and I use these a lot in for all sorts of stuff, and we're going to look at videos later on what I'll use it for. Anyway, this one is bronze, and this is the only one I can find right now. I have some other ones, but the bronze really looks good. I really like it a lot. So I'm going to see what the bronze and the blue end up looking like together. I use normal Sharpies for these. There are fluorescent Sharpies you can buy, and as well as fluorescent paints and glow-in-the-dark paints and glow-in-the-dark markers. So you can use all sorts of bright and fluorescent and glow-in-the-dark ink for these as well, especially if you're looking for more of a spell-like effect, which probably would show up pretty well under a black light or maybe under very, very dim lighting or no lighting at all. Talk about therapeutic. I mean, this is great stuff. This is so relaxing, especially if it turns out the way you want it to, right? I want there to be a scheme. I want there to be a pattern, but I don't want it to really be, well, I mean, I probably couldn't do it if I wanted to, but I really don't want it to look too symmetric. I want it to be a little bit, I don't know, almost chaotic, almost just like some sort of raw source of divine or whatever, power or energy, you know, whatever. And just a fun kind of effect here, just something kind of definitely different. And I normally would do this a little differently, but since I'm trying to show you guys, kind of doing it a little bit upside down. So a little more challenging than usual, but that's all right. You guys are worth it. The one here is going to be more like a shield effect, I think. Some sort of magical shield, perhaps, something like that. So in order to make the shield happen, though, I need to get a bottle cap. And once I have that, I'm going to get my handy-dandy utility knife. And much like I did for the video where you make your own figures, paper figures, I just cut pretty much right down the middle. And then on the other side, except for these, you'll want to make the hole a little bit bigger. I actually messed up. I should have made that a little bit bigger. So you want to make the hole a little bit bigger, the slot here, so that you got a little room. And also, a little bit different, you want to go down a little bit on the edges. Not all the way. Try not to go all the way, but you will want to go down some. So it's kind of tricky on the edges. You've got to try your best to make the blade stop about halfway down. And we'll simply want to prime coat that black. You can use Sharpies for the bottle top that we cut open, but you can, to me it looks a little bit better if you just use a primer, a black primer. And once you do that, then you can simply stand the shield up. And if you like, you can glue it in there, but I have a tendency, you know, to want to just use different setups and so forth. So I would actually use this as an AoE disc for some sort of effect or whatever, some sort of spell or something. So don't really like to limit my discs that much. So I don't glue them, but you can. Wildflower and her awesome companion Fluffy are walking down a nice quiet country road one day when all of a sudden, to their shock and surprise, they are confronted and attacked by three vicious, no good, cowardly bandit archers. Immediately, Wildflower casts uses a defensive ability and sets up some sort of shield to defend herself and her friend Fluffy. And the bandits find the shield seems to absorb their arrows. And then she casts, there we go, Sunburst on the middle archer. And as you see, that works rather well as it gets all three archers in the area of effect. And now they all, of course, since she's so awesome, they all three fail their saving throw. So they're all three blinded. And now Fluffy gets breakfast, lunch, and dinner all at the same time. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, if you got anything out of it, please give us a like. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. And hope you guys enjoyed this. It was a lot of fun. It's always fun to make these. It's just so simple. Really, if you make just one of them, it probably won't take you 15 minutes for the whole thing. It's according to how much artwork you put into it. I put a little bit more artwork into this one, which I think turned out pretty cool. I use this one for electrical and like cold effects and so forth. And you can also use these for auras. I forgot to mention that. And you might want to make one, or like this one, has a flat, kind of a flat top, and you can make a flatter top with the hot glue. And you can just set the figure on top of it, and then it's an effect for an aura. So shields, area of effect, blast markers, I guess. And auras. So good stuff here. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. Thanks for watching.